Hello guys, welcome watching fifth part of our video tutorial how to fix or repair your power washer, pressure washer Nilfisk E 140.3. In this fifth part we will focus on how to change or how to replace non-return valve. Non-return valve is one of the common reasons why the your power washer is pulsating. Actually, that's the second thing that you have to check if you have already checked the high pressure hose for leaks or pressure gun wand for leaks. That's the second thing. People usually do buy start-stop valve right away, but it doesn't make any sense because most of the time it's not the start-stop valve that is causing problem, but it's something else. So today I'll show you what kind of instruments we will need to do the repair. Again, we will need silicone grease liquid moly, pliers, instrument like this, maybe a little hammer, nylon pick or thin flat screwdriver for picking up or taking out the O-rings, Torx 20 screwdriver and flat screwdriver. The item we are going to replace, non-return valve, has right now the part number 128-500-624. This specific part is compatible with pressure washers Nilfisk E133, E143-3, E145-3. As you can see, I don't have a spare part because actually I don't need to replace it because mine is alright. So I just printed the page what you will get in the package. So you will get a spring, one O-ring and one plastic part like this with the O-ring on the top of it. And that's practically everything. First of all, we will remove the two Torx 20 screws from the bottom side and remove the feet. Like this. And I can put it aside. Next step. Remove styling cover, the blue one, have a look at the top and make sure that the two hooks on the top are in correct position, like this. I meant these two hooks. Again, we will place it aside. Now I'll get rid of the filter. Next step, remove another Torx 20 screw. And remove MPU floating cover. That's this part. It's a little bit damaged, but it doesn't matter. And now the process, actually the process of replacing the non-return valve in this particular power washer is very straightforward, very easy. Anybody can handle it, handle the repair, compared to other models, other Nilfisk models or other hobby brands. So the next step is to use flat screwdrivers to take out this pin over here. Remove it from the top. Thank you.
We are nearly there.
Okay, so this metal U-pin is out.
Now you've got access to where the non-return valve is. So you take out the inlet pipe, and now I forgot to mention that we will need tweezers, metal tweezers, for picking up small object, for example like this one. And you can take out the spring either with the thin flat screwdriver or with these tweezers. So for the spring I use a thin screwdriver. The spring looks like this, and usually when this spring is broken, that's the one of the common causes of the pulsating power washer. I'll put it aside, just don't lose it please. And with these tweezers I'll take out the plastic part that is at the bottom of the hole. It's for picking up small objects, and as you can see I got this small plastic part with the O-ring on the top of it. So that's basically how you remove the old damaged non-return valve. And another thing is that you have to remove the old O-ring that is on the pipe. So you will remove it either with the nylon pick if you've got one. If you don't have one, you can use either very thin flat screwdriver. This one is even better. And take it out if you got, because in the package that you received when you bought it, you should have an O-ring as well. And just you will, I won't take it out now because mine O-ring is all right and I'm not gonna change it. I'll just show you that it's this one over here, if you can see it. So you will just replace it. Make sure please that when you replace it you use a silicone grease and grease it properly. And then take out of the new package the new plastic part with the O-ring on the top of it and put it inside the hole. Make sure that it's there properly. And the next step, and very important step, is that you position in the proper position spring. You will see yourself whenever it's there and it fits properly. Okay, I got it. And the next step is to connect the inlet pipe, put it back into the hole and push it in. Push it in whenever, how much it goes. I got it. And the next step is again the U-pin. With this U-pin you have to help yourself with this kind of instrument and squash it a little bit, temporary, and put it into the two holes where it should be. Okay, I got it. And then use a hammer gently, very gently, to make sure that it is there placed properly. Okay, so now we have successfully replaced the non-return valve and we are going to reassemble those parts that we disassembled, and we will start with the MPU floating cover. make sure that this foam over here, this foam is protecting the cable that is a micro switch cable. Make sure that it's placed there, and then position this MPU floating cover like this. And tighten the Torx 20 screw. Okay, I got it. The next step is placing back the styling cover, front styling cover. So make sure that the two hooks are in a correct position and fit it there. I got it. Now we can connect the this kind of filter or proper original transparent Nilfisk one. And the last step is to connect the feet with these two Torx 20 screws. Like this. As you can see, it's a very easy, pretty straightforward process. You don't have to go to service. You will save yourself a lot of money, time, and the nerves. And you can do it yourself if you've got proper instruments at home. Or if you don't have ones, ask your friend. And now you've got your power washer ready for work. No pulsating. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Good luck. And bye.